Ooh, we are live. Hello, hello, hello to all camera angles here. My Facebook people here, my Instagram people here, my GoPro people, what's good? You never know if you're gonna get cut out because of the music, because of technology. So we've got multiple outlets for today's workout so that everyone can enjoy it and post it on WeTube, YouTube, all the tubes. I'm just gonna take a little bit of this to get me in the flow. If you're using cannabis today, feel free to get started with me. All right, good morning. Hey Sean, hey, sparking it. Hey Alicia, good morning. So nice to see you guys. So actually next Monday, I'm gonna be in New York City. Never been, gonna try to do a Lit Fit Live, but I actually might be driving back on Monday. So I'll keep you guys posted, but hopefully I'll be able to do a live somewhere, like maybe in a park or something. So yeah, I'm excited about that. But that brings me to today. Today's theme workout is core cardio and courage. For me, I know confidence, you know, it starts in the core, having that strong base of support and being able to endure through that. It really helps build our courage. And I feel like I need that because not only am I going to New York this week, in 2 weeks I'm going to the Bahamas and I haven't traveled in like a year. So I'm kind of like, about leaving my dog and, you know, just putting myself out there. And with new people, with my boyfriend and his family and stuff. So we're gonna focus on courage today. We're gonna focus on our core and some cardio. So let's smoke to that. I hope you guys are all doing great out there. I hope you're enjoying the summer. I hope you're traveling. and feeling really good in your bodies. And if you're not, thank you for being here today, because I hope when you leave, you're gonna feel even better. So we are high, we're getting high. Let's get healthy with it. And we're gonna get right into today's workout. So my Facebook people, you're kind of cut off, but make sure you head over to Instagram to get the full bod shot. My Instagram people, GoPro, we're good. So today, let's go ahead. We're gonna start in a seated position. Y'all know a little meditation is good for the brain, good for our focus, really coming into our heart space today. So if it feels good for you, let's close those eyes. Let's deepen that breath here. A nice inhale and exhale flow. And if you want to move with your meditation, please do. Maybe a little inhale as you reach forward. Exhale as you come up. Inhale, reach it forward. Exhale, reach it up. And we're just coming here into our breath so that we can focus on feeling our core today. Building our courage through our solar plexus. And definitely just building that cardio endurance so that we can stay strong, we can stay courageous no matter what environment we're in, right? We're always in our home and our home and our peace. Bringing those hands back to the heart. Just set a little intention for today. If your intention is to build courage, to build your core strength, to increase your cardio endurance, those are open. If you have something else in mind today, go for that. Just give yourself a moment here to just think that, feel it, and then let yourself be it today in class, okay? physically just feel it. Probably like, yeah, it's in my bones. So we're gonna stay here on the ground, but we're gonna crisscross applesauce the opposite direction. We're gonna plant our right fingertips into the ground, reach our left arm up, our left arm over. And then we're just gonna flow here, getting some mobility through our rib cage, warming up our lateral core today so that we can be dynamic, strong, endured. I know I already said all these words like 10 times, but I want you guys to really feel it, because when you feel it is where the magic happens. Feeling that stretch from the hip to the armpit. Taking those left fingertips, root them in towards the ground. Take your right fingertips open. And then from here, we're gonna move into a side plank. So you can be in a side plank where your knees are stacked. Modified here. You could be in a full side plank. Remember, we're still warming up, but you're here. It's up to you this morning, what feels good. I'm gonna go modified here. Keep that arm reached over. And then warming up our belly some more, I'd like you to drive your hips anterior towards me, towards your camera, and then posterior, send your butt back. So we're just pressing our hips forward, opening up our hips, warming up our belly, and then back, lengthening our back, warming up our lower back muscles. Finding our dynamic stability here in this strong core position. And it should just feel good, natural. For a three, a two, one. Come back to the center here. Let's find a center plank. And again, you can be modified here on your knees. You can be lifted off of those knees. It's up to you. This feels really good here. Nice full plank for me today. Same idea. We're going to drop our hips anterior and posterior. I don't think I need to explain this because I'm sure you guys are feeling it, but really working, it's almost like a crunch with gravity. It's a lot through your hips, through your belly. A couple more. It's almost like an upward facing dog, and then before you go to a downward facing dog, you feel that little belly squeeze. Let's go two more. I'm throwing my hair up. You're still in your plank. Good. And then you're gonna switch sides, finding your side plank on the opposite side. Plant those hands, plant that hand. You have three hands. Modified or full side plank, it's up to you. And then again, we're gonna drive our hips anterior and posterior. I hope you guys can hear Gorilla Black on the tunes right now. It goes perfect with that beat. Let's flow it. Using that breath here, you're feeling your abdominals work as you drive your hips just a little forward and a little back. For three, two, and one. Come back to the center. Find yourself a nice child's pose. Drop those hips back. And then we're gonna inhale, come on up to a floating tabletop. Exhale, push it back to your child's pose. Maybe you want to find a little side to side lateral motion here, and then come back into that floating tabletop and drop it back. Remember, courage, you know you need courage when you feel maybe a little uncomfortable going outside of your comfort zone. You gotta be that person that inspires you to do that, right? No one else can do that really for you. So that's what I'm asking from you today, is going outside of your comfort zone, being courageous. And while you're doing that, you're getting some cardio in, you're getting some core, you're having a good time. Two. And if you're not, make it a little bit more fun. Let's go. Two. And one. Good. Now find that downward facing dog. My yoga people, drive your hips up, drop through the neck and the shoulders. Let that blood come up into your brain. Dropping those knees. Coming back into your seated position here. I just want you guys to just get a little inside scoop of what we were just doing. We're doing side planks with hip drivers in one plane of motion. We have two more planes of motion. So we're gonna do that plank sequence two more times, all right? So if you need water, if you need cannabis throughout any of that, go for it. But really remember, be courageous, step outside your comfort zone, and feel your hips and your pelvis move today. Your center of confidence, your core. All right, so let's find our side plank. Remember, you can always be modified here. You can always be on an elbow if your wrists are funky. But come on, you're strong out there. Let's do it. I'm taking a full side plank here. Now, this one's a little bit maybe trickier, just depending on where your core strength is. We're gonna drop our hips, lift our hips here. Yep, you saw it. Drop it, lift it. Now, you're like a piece of toast in a toaster. I always use this analogy because you're not rotating. You're not driving your hips forward and back. You're just going down and up. Let's go. Really feeling your core here. If you're not, drop me a message. Say, I'm not feeling my core. I will walk you through it personally in a Lit Fit virtual sesh. Let's go one more. So you should really be feeling it. Good. Come on down. Drop your butt. Give yourself a nice big hug. Round it on in. Really surrendering here to your potential. Rotate that right chin or that right to your right shoulder to your left. That's all I'm gonna say. Surrendering to your potential. That can be scary sometimes because we're really powerful, potent beings. You know what I'm saying? If there's anything you might feel when you're high, I hope it's that. Your power, your potential, all the love fluctuating through your body. Let's take it that side plank on the opposite side. Reach that arm up. If you're in a full plank with me, let's do that. Remember, your foot can be stacked. It can be lifted. You can be here. It's all up to you. Now, driving those hips, frontal plane, drop it, reach it up. Nice and fluid here. If it's not fluid, that's okay. That just means we're building some muscle memory. That's where the magic happens, the strength, the stability. Keep going. If you're not feeling it, remember, let me know. I feel this every time and I've been doing it for a bit. Five, four, three, two, one. Come on down. We're gonna take a couple of circles in our child's pose. Just loosening up our wrists that we put all the pressure on, loosening up our hips, all that work in our core. Going with your groove today, making it feel good. Take a couple in the opposite direction. You guys know I'm all about feeling good in your body. That's what matters most. You show up, you do your best, and you make it feel good. Good. Come back to the center. Find your last plank in the frontal plane. Center here. Now we're gonna drive our hips side to side. If your feet need to be a little bit wider, spread them. And then let's go. Drive those hips to the right, to the left. So hopefully you guys are feeling your core not only work, but your heart rate's up. And you're hearing Akon in the background. Let's go, a couple more. Really feeling gravity here, work your core and your muscles activate against gravity. For 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Come on down. Grab some water. Grab a stretch, grab your cannabis. Hey guys. Sean. Cuddy. Thanks, Sean. I appreciate you. Appreciate that. Alrighty guys. Hope you're feeling really good out there, really warmed up. We're gonna continue with some cardio, some core. We're gonna take a standing position. So, we're gonna start real simple here. Right foot steps right. You're gonna bend down, you're gonna load into that right hip. Take it back to the center. Load into your left hip. So the idea here, I'd really like you to get that load and that mobilization through your ankle, right? So it's okay if your knee comes over your toe. It's all right. If it moves there, let's do it. Doesn't have to be a big step, just enough for you. Most of all, feel those feet alive today. And then find your groove. For real though, you can reach down to the ground, you can rotate, just something that's gonna spark your heart rate. Maybe your arms wanna be up and reach back. Good, one more. Coming back to the center. Let's reach out to those toes, drop through the head, neck, and the shoulders, shake it out. We're gonna do another round of that, but we're gonna switch up what you do with your arms, and we're gonna maybe do it a little bit quicker, okay? So, let's go, step it right, boom. Step it left, boom. Play around with what you wanna do in your arms. Maybe you wanna rotate today. Rotate. Maybe you're like, Kendra, I'm good with just here. And I'd say, Do that. And then maybe we're gonna go a little bit quicker. Use your core, we already warmed it up. Twist through your belly, your pelvic floor muscles. Hopefully you guys can hear the music. Let's go. 3, 2, 1. Come back to the center. Quick feet in and out. Let's go. Kind of like a jumping jack. We'll call it a jumping jack. Let's do those arms. Let's jump and jack anterior. Let's jump and jack posterior. Let's jump and jack to the right, to the left. Let's rotate it as we jump and jack. Getting that cardio going. Let's rotate to the other side. Good. Come back to the center. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, fold. Couple of breaths here. Finding your recovery. Nice job, guys. Hopefully that really got your heart rate up. We're gonna continue to go with that cardio, core, all the above. So, from here, what I'd like you guys to do. Left foot forward, right foot back. Mobilizing in a little bit of a squat. All right, again, making it feel good. Letting those knees come forward. Letting that butt go back. Use your core here, feel your center aligned with your head, with your roots, with your feet. 2, 1, switch it. Good, that opposite foot's forward. Remember, it's not about doing it right, okay? Because what's right for you is different from what's right for me, because our bodies are all balanced differently. But we are trying to find fluidity in our body and work with our imbalances, and then we will find our balance, right? So maybe you need to go lower. Maybe you need to plant your foot. It doesn't matter. Just get your rhythm, find your groove, and everything else will even out. Let's go a couple more, and then we're gonna crisscross this. If you're like, oh, what's a crisscross? You're about to find out. Crisscross. Get ready to go. 4, 3, 2, 1. Crisscross it. Squat it. So, little plyometrics here. Nice and gentle. Still working that strength in our lower body, in our cardio, in our core. Let your low back open here. So a lot of times we're like here and then we're like here, you know? Nah, we gotta use those muscles. Let your low back here support this movement, support your core so you can really get like Spider-Man with it, right? That's what we're trying to do. Get loose with it. 10 more seconds. Oh, don't trip over your mat. You see my Spider-Man reflexes though? You know what I'm saying? 2, 1. Slow it down, shake it out. Let's go ahead now, crisscross our feet. Reach towards those toes. Find your recovery here in this stretch. In this surrender. Not getting too high in the highs, not getting too low on the lows, right? Love you, buddy. Switch legs. Breath here, find that stretch, find that feel good after all that work, that yin to that yang. Beautiful. Grab some water after that one, y'all. Grab some water. We need some cannabis. Grab that. Hey, Susan, good to see you. I send my blessings to you and to Curry. Miss y'all. Let me know if you come back in Florida. Be nice to see you. Say hi. Alrighty, y'all. Let me just double check what time it is here. We got about 4 more minutes. We're gonna continue with some core, with some cardio, with some courage building. Find a boat pose position. So our heels are planted, our chest is nice and long and lifted. We're gonna reach forward towards our toes and then we're gonna shoot it back. Reach it, shoot it back. So again, playing with momentum here, playing with gravity. Everybody ready? That's the 3-minute cool down, but we're still warm. So let's keep going here. You're still reaching back and forward. We're gonna do this in 3D, because you all know about that 3D movement, that 3D life. One more. Good, coming back to your center. A little reach back so you can get that work through your belly, right? Drive those hands up. Let's go ahead and reach them right lateral, reach them left lateral. Again, like you are a piece of toast in a toaster. It's not gonna be perfect, but that's what we're aiming for. So that's when you can really use those muscles in your body at different angles and build their strength, their coordination, their stability. Let's go for 3, 2, 1. Give yourself a little bit of rest here, taking a butterfly position. Drop through the head, neck, and the shoulders. Maybe rotating up that neck, reaching that neck. If you're building any tension up your neck, the idea is to release it before we go into our last position. Boat pose in it, drive those arms out, and then we're gonna bring them around to the right, around to the left. And hopefully you guys not only feel your core, feel that heart rate, feel you moving outside your comfort zone, building your mental core, your mental endurance. And we all know courage comes from right in here, and of course in our heart, but we're sneaking them together. Let's go. 2, 1. Take a big butterfly again. Maybe rounding through. And then if you want, plant those hands, open up your butterfly. Remember, it's not about how you move, it's about how you feel when you are moving. Do you feel tight? Do you feel tense? Do you feel like you're doing something like wrong or naughty? That's okay. Because we're trying to normalize that. Normalize it with you, not with anyone else, just you and how you feel with your body. Because if you're like, okay, I feel a little odd, awkward, a little dirty, but it's coming from a genuine place. My body just likes to move like that. That's you, that's your real essence, that's your confidence coming out. All right, and that's how we build that, is we do it. Let's go one more. Coming on up, finding your meditation space. One more time. Bring one hand to your heart, one hand to your core. And just thank your belly and all those muscles today for showing up to support you in this workout. And for your heart to show up, to be open-minded and to receive all the benefits of this Lit Fit class with me. I appreciate you and your body. As always, have a high and healthy day. Great job. Nama Lit Fit. And if you guys didn't feel any of those today, or if you're like, wow, I really like those, I want to learn more. MindBodyPhysique.com, book a Lit Fit virtual session. And we can do just like this, 45 minutes. Twice a week if you'd like. That's for best results. And that's it, guys. Hopefully I'll see you next week. If not, y'all know I'm gonna be in New York. Woo! New York City! And yeah, till then, stay lit, stay fit, stay high, stay healthy. Have a blessed week. Peace.